Tonight, political interference. Why environmental groups are saying that's happening with Minnesota congressmen and a proposed copper nickel mine.
And in the spotlight for the second night in a row, a Northlander spoke at the Republican National Convention.
Plus, keeping traditions alive. That's what apple farmers are trying to do in Bayfield after their biggest festival was canceled.
From CBS 3 Duluth, this is the CBS 3 News at 6.
Good evening, I'm Kristen Bakke.
And I'm Anthony Matt. Thanks for joining us. We are expecting to hear from Minnesota Governor Tim Walz any minute now. He's going to be addressing the ongoing situation in the Twin Cities.
Before we hear from the governor, let's catch you up on the last 24 hours. Hostile crowds gathered in Minneapolis late last night. According to the police, the civil unrest started after a man connected to a homicide killed himself as officers approached him on Nicollet Mall.
An immediate curfew was instituted at about 9:30 last night by Mayor Jacob Frey, and about 90 minutes later, Governor Tim Walz declared a peacetime emergency and deployed the Minnesota National Guard. However, crowds in the surrounding area still destroyed many businesses. We are expecting to hear from the governor, as we mentioned. Doesn't sound like he's quite ready yet, but if he is ready during the 6 o'clock newscast, we will take him live. In the meantime, let's go over to Dave for a quick look at the weather. Dave, you're tracking the potential for some rain, huh?
Yeah, there's yet another low pressure system over towards the Dakotas heading our way, and could happen as the night goes on. So first, clouds will be on the increase this evening, and then the high pressure goes away that brought us sunshine today, and the low brings in a 50, 60, 70, even 80% chance for showers and storms here on Friday. Let's talk about how much rain could come down, because some charts are indicating a lot. Others are indicating just a little. This one's a little bit more towards the little side, thinking that about a tenth to a quarter of an inch could fall in Minnesota, but more like a quarter to even an inch in Wisconsin and parts of the Upper Peninsula, a third for Ironwood and a third for Watersmeet there as well, but towards a half inch once you get to Mercer, Wisconsin. All right, so the forecast here, the day planner for Friday says it's a 40% chance of rain after midnight tonight through sunrise tomorrow. Picks up towards 70 to even 80% in the afternoon, but should already be gone and starting to clear back up once we get home. The cold front associated with this latest low is going to take temperatures down. In fact, tomorrow may only achieve 70 or so, and that may be the trend for the weekend too, but at least that'll be with sunshine, and we'll show you all of this with the 7-day forecast coming up in a few more minutes.
Thanks, Dave. New at 6, a judge ruled today a man charged in connection to a decades-old murder on the Iron Range will stay in jail while his court case plays out. Police arrested Michael Allen Carbo Jr. in late July after a break in Nancy Doherty's murder. The Chisholm woman was found dead in her home 34 years ago. She'd been beaten, sexually assaulted, and strangled. Authorities say new DNA evidence connected Carbo to her murder just last month. According to the Mesabi Tribune, Carbo's attorney asked the judge to drop his $1 million bail, asking for supervised release instead. The judge said no, saying people in the community would have a legitimate fear of Carbo. He's scheduled to be back in court next month.
Governor Walz, as we mentioned, is speaking now live on the ongoing situation in Minneapolis. We're going to listen in now.
It was in St. Paul, and then spent the day calling leaders in the black community and talking about what we saw and trying to make sure that this important conversation we've been having about the safety in our communities and the sense of inclusion for everyone is not lost in what is obviously lawless behavior that's dangerous, and how are we making sure we separate that? That conversation has to be done. That conversation on equity, whether it's in our schools or health outcomes, has to happen. It cannot happen when violence is prevailing. It cannot happen when our cities do not feel safe. It cannot happen when businesses are targeted at a time when we need every single business we can operating the best we can because of COVID-19. So just to be clear, those conversations that we're moving forward on need to continue to happen. But over the next 12 hours, our certain concern, as it always is safety and security and bringing peace into the city. So we just want to reassure Minnesotans that that the state is there to support the city of Minneapolis. We have approximately 300 National Guard troops prepared to support the law enforcement, and keeping in mind that that is their role in support of law enforcement. We have about 250 state patrol that have been tasked, in addition to DNR and other state assets, and then the joint powers agreements, making sure that I would stress we need the help again of folks. 8 o'clock curfew in both Minneapolis and St. Paul. Transit is running. We want to make sure people can get out and get home, but we certainly can't allow the behavior that happened last night. It closes down the discussions. It puts people at risk. It simply is unacceptable. In a time in our nation that the unrest and the distrust is running high, Minnesota needs to be that example. I said it at the end of May, and I'll continue to say it. We have the opportunity to be defined either by what happened to George Floyd in these continued acts, or we can be defined on how we respond to them. And this gives us an opportunity that this situation that happened in the unfortunate homicide and suicide that set this off, we can't allow those situations to happen. It simply does not allow us to have the conversations that we need to have, or to live, to be quite honestly, the types of lives that we know we want and we want for our children. So I'd like to have Commissioner Harrington from DPS update on the current situation on the ground, and then we'll be glad to answer any questions with all of us.
Good evening. John Harrington, Commissioner of the Department.
Well, meanwhile, several environmental groups and businesses are alleging Representatives Pete Stauber and Tom Emmer interfered in the lease renewal process for Twin Metals. The amended complaint was filed Thursday in U.S. District Court. It alleges emails from Stauber and Emmer's legislative assistants used, quote, undue political interference. It adds that they allegedly removed a stipulation that would have required the U.S. Forest Service agree to any future mineral lease renewal issued by the Bureau of Land Management. The coalition behind the complaint says the Forest Service did not uphold its legal obligation to analyze and justify its decisions approving mineral leases and renewal of leases. In a statement, Representative Stauber said he has always believed these projects should have a fair, rigorous regulatory process.
A logging representative from northern Minnesota took the stage at the RNC last night. Scott Dane is the executive director of the Associated Contract Loggers and Truckers of Minnesota, which is based in Gilbert. Dane talked about the importance of logging in our American history and thanked President Trump for highlighting forest management. He also took shots at the Obama-Biden administration, blaming the pair for closing down mills across Minnesota.
But the last time Joe Biden was in the White House, Minnesota lost nearly half of its mills, thousands of jobs, and experienced nearly a decade of decline. In 47 years in Washington, Joe Biden hasn't done anything for the timber industry.
Meanwhile, Vice President Mike Pence will be in Duluth tomorrow. We're expecting him to be here early afternoon. We will be carrying the entire visit online as well as on air.
Bayfield's legendary Apple Fest has been canceled due to COVID-19.
Well, the weekend filled with events might not be happening, drawing thousands to the small northwest Wisconsin town. Apple orchards are still trying to keep traditions alive. CBS3's Emma Quinn has the juicy details.
A committee of apple orchard owners and other Bayfield leaders decided to cancel the legendary Apple Fest here in Bayfield this year to ensure safety for the coronavirus pandemic. But a new celebration is on its way to ensure profit comes and you can get your favorite apple treat. Fred Erickson, owner of Erickson Orchards in Bayfield, says they made the decision, saying it would be irresponsible to bring 60,000 people into the Bayfield community. Instead, the orchards will celebrate their own harvests individually, known as a celebration of harvest. It'll be held over a three-week period when Apple Fest would have taken place. Erickson says without the usual festival, they'll still have a great season.
We do an orchard maze here and hay rides and things like that. So it's going to work, and I believe that we're going to have a great year.
Erickson adds all the farms have plenty of space to keep people socially distanced. The celebration of harvest will include live music and some food vendors. Due to food and safety regulations, dogs will not be allowed.
Looks good. Apple Fest would have taken place from October 2nd to the 4th. Harvest celebrations will happen the weekend before and after. We have more details on our website.
$24,000 per dose. That's what a young Iron Range native is being asked to pay for a medication he needs to battle his Crohn's disease. 23-year-old Colton Croft was diagnosed in 2017 and has since experienced several complications and failed treatments. After undergoing a surgery to remove 19 inches of his small intestine last year, Colton was on the mend. He started a new treatment called Stelara, which has been working for him. But after 5 rounds of the ongoing treatment, Colton was told his primary insurance wouldn't cover the 6th dose, leaving him to find a way to foot the bill to the tune of $24,000, something neither the 23-year-old nor his parents can afford. But there's a major consequence to Colton not receiving his treatments on time.
And the part about biologic therapy is that you can get immune to these drugs if you don't take them when you're supposed to take them. So the insurance company denying me my Stelara now could ultimately make me immune to this drug.
Colton is now speaking out about his ongoing healthcare struggles in hopes of raising awareness and connecting with those who may be going through the same thing. Hear from Colton and his parents tonight on the CBS 3 News at 10.
Still to come on Live Local CBS 3, Hurricane Laura caused devastating damage in the Gulf Coast. Find out how one Northlander is lending a helping hand.
Temperatures today hit 78 degrees at the airport in Duluth, 6 degrees warmer than normal, but a cool down is coming. Just wedged in between is another rain chance, maybe some thunderstorms too. That'll be tomorrow, and we'll talk about how long it'll last right after our break.
Live, local, CBS 3 News at 6 with Kristen Vaki, Anthony Matt, Kelly Hinson, and weather with meteorologist Dave Anderson on Live, local, CBS 3. Watch Dave, Caitlin, and Austin for local weather you can trust on CBS.
Keep scrolling. Order food. Skip headlines. Order shoes. Use AutoSend for flowers. Use AutoSend for birthdays. Don't go outside. Don't go outside. Don't leave the phone behind. No sync. Don't blink. Don't think. Don't ever let yourself feel this alive. Breathe. Ride.
Welcome to Medical Insight, a weekly healthcare feature brought to you by the experts at Essentia Health. Here's your host, Louis St. George.
Today on Medical Insight, Essentia Health cardiologist Raman Artang tells us about calcium scoring, a preventive test for people age 45 or older.
A coronary calcium score is a CT scan of the chest, where we primarily focus on amount of calcium that can be seen in the heart. Calcium comes due to the disease process of coronary artery disease. As we age, some of the plaques that are developing in the vessels, with time they calcify, and that's what we can actually measure with the x-ray that the CT scan is.
This 15-minute scan is critical in determining one's risk for serious health events, such as a heart attack, over the next 5 to 10 years.
Let's say a gentleman in his 50s with significant family history of coronary artery disease get this test and get a relative high score. Having calcium in your heart definitely pushes toward the fact that you need to be on medication such as cholesterol lowering medication, because it's proof that coronary artery disease process is going on in the heart. If your cholesterols were a little high but you have absolutely no calcium in your heart, that would allow the doctor to say, well, there's not much going on here, we can wait. This test is not for people who actually have chest pain symptoms or shortness of breath symptoms. This test is for people who with no symptoms whatsoever, but who have a risk factor such as diabetes, such as a long-standing history of smoking, such as high cholesterol or high blood pressure, who are afraid there's something bad waiting for them.
For Medical Insight, I'm Louis St. George.
To learn more about this and other health topics, visit EssentiaHealth.org/MedicalInsight.
News is brought to you by Fond du Lac Casino. Watch Jeopardy at 4:30, followed by CBS 3 Live at 5 on Live Local CBS 3. Now, the CBS 3 Duluth WeatherMax Forecast with meteorologist Dave Anderson.
Here's a live look at Cass Lake, and we're eyeing up the sky, watching the clouds thicken up as our latest low pressure system comes to the area. Today we had higher pressure take over for a few hours, so it was pretty nice, still warm and summery. Sky was blue after yesterday's rain. Now we go back towards the rain for Friday before we return to sunshine for the weekend, so that's actually fairly good timing for folks who get the weekends off. As someone who worked weekends around here for 20 years, I know how you feel if you do have to work Saturday and Sunday. and then you don't get out to enjoy the fine weather. Well, fine weather is what we're going to have no matter what your employment status is, and we'll talk about this storm chance here on Friday here after we take a look at the current conditions that are coming in from the airport at 75, 60% for the relative humidity, easterly, southeasterly winds hitting 6 miles an hour, and the air pressure is holding fairly steady at 29.87, kind of in the netherworld between being high and low. But it likely will fall as the low pressure system from the Dakotas comes in with those increasing clouds. And that'll help lead to decreasing temperatures. So right now it's fairly summery, but it's going to get chillier than this in just a little bit. 73 to 76 current numbers for the Upper Peninsula. Looks like 75 to 77 for much of northwestern Wisconsin. 77s are found in Hayward and Superior. Oh, now it's dropped to 74 degrees for our friends in Superior. 75 is the current temp in Moose Lake. We have 73 from Two Harbors towards Silver Bay, and then 72 to 75 from the Vermilion Range towards the Mesabi, and getting towards 78 degrees once you get around the Cuyuna. 73 degrees current temperature for much of border country. Low temps tonight, probably upper 50s to lower 60s. Daytime highs tomorrow, lower 70s a little more likely as our summer-style temperatures slip away as August slips away as well. Doppler map right now shows the clearer sky trying to slip away towards the east as clouds start to take over the area, pushing in from the west, associated with a lower pressure system right now centered in the Dakotas. In our neck of the woods, that'll bring us a 70-80% chance for thunderstorms on Friday, and it may be a bit of a soaker for some towns, especially for Wisconsin, again, because Tropical Storm Laura will be pulling Gulf of Mexico moisture into the system here and then converting that into rain. That hopefully will be done by Friday night. So we may get a soaker during the daylight hours on Friday, but it goes away by the weekend as higher pressure from Canada brings back the sun. On the other hand, though, it'll help drive a cold front into the region that, like I mentioned, will take temperatures down into the lower 70s for much of the rest of the week ahead, maybe even some 60s too. So tonight in Minnesota, look for low temps 55 to about 61 with clouds on the increase. In Wisconsin and Michigan, they'll increase there as well with low temps, well, 57 to 60. From the increased clouds then in Wisconsin, Michigan tomorrow, we get that 80% chance for the showers and storms. High temp 70 to 74 in Minnesota. Lower 70s inland, 60s by the lake, 70% chance for the showers and storms. But if it gets a little bit loud and bumpy for a little while on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday should be calming. Calm weather, calming the nerves. High temps near 70 with at least a partly cloudy sky. Next rain chance, though, Tony and Kristen, it comes around on Monday again already. Getting cloudy with a 60% shot for another round of showers and storms.
Thanks, Dave. Hurricane Laura caused devastating damage to eastern Texas and western Louisiana when it made landfall. Now a Northland nurse is leading the relief effort. John Decker has been working disaster relief for the Red Cross for the last 12 years. With all that experience, he's become one of the organization's lead members. He says this hurricane has been difficult because they're not just dealing with the storm.
Operating in the pandemic environment has been extremely challenging. As we prepare to simultaneously do two disasters at the same time.
Decker says he is extremely grateful for how well the Red Cross has prepared for disasters like this. Donating to the organization is one way you can help.
Six horses in northwest Wisconsin have tested positive for a rare deadly disease. According to the State Department of Health, the horses tested positive for Eastern Equine Encephalitis, or EEE. They were located in Chippewa, Dunn, and Pepin counties. Health officials say infected mosquitoes likely pass the disease to the horses. They can also infect humans and other animals. While health officials say it's a rare virus in Wisconsin, this latest detection means you should be extra cautious of mosquito bites.
Coming up in sports, the protests continue among professional sports. Kelly has the latest coming up.
Get your new UTV from Duluth Lawn and Sport, the region's largest power sports dealer.
CBS 3 Live Cams are brought to you by Kohler Chevrolet Buick GMC Cadillac. The TED event is happening now, where you're not just getting a car, you're getting Kohler.
During the Labor Day sale at Home Furniture, everything's on sale, up to 30% off. Every sofa, sectional, and recliner. Get free no-contact shipping, plus no-interest financing until 2024. The Labor Day sale, now at Home Furniture.
Do you have a coffee smile? Drinking coffee causes yellow teeth for thousands of people just like you. And whitening toothpaste just doesn't make those stains go away. Introducing Power Swabs, the first teeth whitening system that lifts coffee stains off your teeth in less than 5 minutes without whitening strips or trays.
I've smoked, I've drank coffee, I drink red wine. It makes my teeth darker. And using Power Swabs, it's made a difference. People ask me, what do you do to whiten your teeth? And I'm really proud to tell them that I use Power Swabs.
This didn't sting, it didn't burn, it didn't have an aftertaste. It was just a swab, and I just got a rubber on my teeth, and that was it.
The secret is a tooth detergent and whitening agent developed by Dr. Martin Ginniker that lifts stains off of your teeth. Power Swabs remove stains on natural teeth, veneers, bonding, caps, and crowns. The best part is you just swab your teeth for 5 minutes and you'll have whiter teeth. No more sitting at home with a whitening strip or tray in your mouth for 30 minutes twice a day.
So with the strips I've used in the past, most of them are like, you got to leave it on for 30 minutes and the whole experience is just not comfortable. But with Power Swabs, I just snapped it open and rubbed it on and it was good to go.
When I used these whitening strips, I noticed when I would drink, I would get this crazy sensitivity. It would go right to my brain and I'm like, I hate this. So why do I have to go through the monstrosity of this pain just because I want to whiten my teeth? With Power Swabs, there was zero sensitivity.
Within the first day with the Power Swab, I noticed there was a difference. I really love the fact that you're able to go individually on each tooth and make sure that it's going to be wider.
Call for your five-minute solution to whiter teeth. Whiten your teeth today by ordering Power Swabs and receive 40% off the regular price. Yes, 40% off the regular price. Shipping is free, plus you'll receive a free quick stick pen. Visit powerswabs.com or call the number on your screen.
If you're driven by an adventurous heart, you're in luck. The Subaru Outback is all new for 2020 with standard symmetrical all-wheel drive plus up to 33 miles per gallon. An available 260 horsepower turbocharged engine, advanced technology, and an extra large touchscreen. Welcome to the best Outback ever, the 2020 Subaru Outback. Go where love takes you.
Lease a 2020 Subaru Outback during the Subaru A Lot to Love event going on now.
Home Furniture presents Stickley. During our Labor Day sale, enjoy 10% savings on all of Stickley's premium solid wood furniture and exquisitely crafted designs during the Labor Day sale. Stickley, exclusively at Home Furniture.
Watch Jeopardy at 4:30, followed by CBS 3 Live at 5 on Live Local CBS 3.
After an unprecedented day in American sports that began with the Milwaukee Bucks opting out of their game yesterday, teams outside the NBA are now following their lead in protest of the recent police-involved shooting of Jacob Blake in Kenosha, Wisconsin. As of 3 o'clock p.m. today, reports were saying that the Minnesota Twins would not be playing tonight's game against the Cleveland Indians. And according to CBS Sports, the Twins will follow suit with many other professional teams. They joined several other Major League Baseball teams who opted not to play today. In a statement, the Twins said that they remain committed to using their platforms and push for racial justice and equality, offering their full respect to their players in their decision not to play. No word yet if they will plan to make up the game at any point. And back in the NBA, players met last night and again today, ultimately deciding that they will continue on with the NBA playoffs. This according to an ESPN report. However, the three games scheduled for today are postponed, just like yesterday's three games. The league has not yet confirmed rescheduled game times, which are expected to be determined by this weekend. Players still plan to meet to determine how to best use their influence to aid in social justice reform. And after being one of the few sports yesterday to not pause any of their playoff games, the NHL decided to stand in solidarity with the NBA and WNBA as well. The league announced that today's two playoff games from the bubble, that includes the Flyers Islanders and Knights Canucks, have been postponed after a strong push from players. San Jose Sharks star Evander Kane put out a call to the NHL on behalf of the newly formed Hockey Diversity Alliance to put a hold on today's games, saying the lack of acknowledgement and an action from the NHL was insulting. That Bucks protest yesterday sparked action around the sports world, as you can see. The WNBA and the MLS called off all their games once again today. The Brewers postponed their game yesterday. They're making up with a doubleheader today.
And since the NFL canceled its preseason, they don't have any games to call off right now. But the Green Bay Packers, along with several other NFL teams, decided to call off their training camp practices today. Head coach Matt LaFleur says no players explicitly said they didn't want to practice, but due to their raw emotion at the morning meetings, he didn't feel comfortable holding a practice. Instead, they will be screening the documentary 13th for players and staff while continuing their conversations. There currently is no plan yet what they will do tomorrow.
There's a lot of raw emotion that comes out in these meetings with players that come from different backgrounds, that come from different experiences, and you feel for these guys and, you know, just want to continue to listen and see what we can do to make a positive impact in this society.
According to multiple reports, the Vikings held similar discussions but ultimately held their practice as planned in Eagan earlier this afternoon. That's going to do it for sports for now. We'll have more back here tonight at 10. For now, Kristen and Tony, I'll send it back to you.
All right, thanks, Kelly. Tonight on the CBS 3 News at 10, in 5 days, the local school district will be opening its doors and welcoming kids back to school. We're taking a deeper look into the preparation that has taken place to keep kids safe during the coronavirus pandemic while they attend school. Well, have you ever felt the need for speed?
I think I know where that's going.
Well, this helmet will take you right into the danger zone.
It was made for Tom Cruise in his 1986 blockbuster Top Gun. The helmet is now going on the auction block in Los Angeles and is expected to fetch more than $65,000. Kristen, want to loan me some money? Cruise played a brash-talking Navy pilot, Pete Maverick Mitchell. The helmet has Eagle stickers and Maverick call signs on it. The studio says 10 helmets were made for Cruise's character, but it's unclear how this one was actually used. And if you're ready for more Top Gun, you're in luck. A long-awaited sequel entitled Top Gun Maverick is set to release in December. I'm a huge Top Gun fan. Caden, our producer, picked that kicker just for me.
And just for you.
So thanks, Caden.
Well, Dave, you have the need for speed. We all know that. You love it all.
Yeah, I get that helmet and wear it on my 72 Articap Puma.
There you go.
Little vintage ride with a vintage helmet. All right, let's talk about the forecast, though, because that's calling for clouds to increase tonight, setting us up for a chance for showers and storms on Friday. And the cold front with this latest low is frankly going to take our temperatures down. We've been so warm this summer, now September's lurking. And temperatures will fall right on cue. For the rest of the week, we'll have highs going about 68 to 72, which will actually undercut normal by a few degrees. Our rain chances this week are Friday and another one on Monday. Otherwise, it should be on the sunnier side.
All right. I'm happy we still have some of these summer temperatures.
A little sunshine.
A little longer. Thanks for joining us.
We'll see you again at 10 o'clock.